Fuel price cuts begin today, but the Philippine Energy Department warns a price hike may be looming next week. Alvin El Chico reports.
Motorists are getting some relief this week as oil firms have announced a rollback in all fuel products. 130 for diesel, 70 centavos for gasoline, and 180 for kerosene. But jeepney drivers are worried that bigger oil price hikes will be back soon.
Mas maganda kung ano lang, rollback.
The Energy Department says fears of another fuel price hike in the coming weeks may have basis as Russia's plan to cut oil production may push world prices to go up.
Pag totally cut the production nila on top of the oil embargo implemented last December, so yung ample supply sa world market apektado. So may chance na tumaas ulit ang presyo.
For LPG, industry sources claim the reduction on March 1 will hover between 4 and 5 pesos per kilo. Meanwhile, the National Grid Corporation has warned of thin electricity supply in the Luzon grid during the summer season due to higher consumption. The grid operator worries about unplanned shutdowns, which already happened before, causing yellow or red alerts. Still on power, the Power for People Coalition has filed a motion for intervention in a case filed by San Miguel Corporation against the Energy Regulatory Commission at the Court of Appeals. The group says San Miguel's contract with Meralco is fixed, but the supplier wants to increase rates to cover for higher fuel prices.
18 kilong bigas ang inagaw na simula Disyembre ng San Miguel Corporation na pinanigan ng Court of Appeals.
The group appeals to the court to also listen to the consumers who eventually pays for the bill and not just to the government, electricity supplier, and power distributor. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Various transport groups are preparing to hold a week-long strike starting March 6. This is to protest a memorandum by the transport regulators which requires all public transport vehicles to be a member of a cooperative or a corporation by June 30th. Now, Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista is appealing for a dialogue with the transport sector before the planned strike.
Siguro dapat pag-isipan natin mabuti yung pag-stop ng operations. No? Dapat mag-usap-usap muna. Let's understand what the issues are. No? Kasi baka hindi tayo nagkakaintindihan, no? But I think it's important that there is a dialogue between the operators, LTFRB, and this time we will have representatives from the OTR, no? Ang problema yata ay hindi nagkaroon ng representatives ang DOTR doon sa mga discussions, no? Para maklarify ko ano man yung mga issues.
Transport groups say they are willing to have a dialogue with the Transportation Department under one condition.
Kailangan scrap po muna nila o i-suspend po yung memorandum circular na inilabas po nila. Nakakatawa kasi naglabas sila ng memorandum circular na dapat yata dumadaan muna ito sa DOTR. Tapos ngayon po sasabihin na mag-usap-usap tayo. Mukhang sila po yung hindi nag-usap-usap bago po nilabas ito.
The Philippine city of Makati shuts down the headquarters of Smart Communications. Local officials say the telco giant has been operating in the city without a business permit since 2019 and has a tax deficiency worth over 3.2 billion pesos.
Did not pay under protest, but they went to the courts to stop us from collecting. After a series of hearings, the court upheld the right of the city. We welcome business in Makati, but you have to do it within the bounds of the law.
The closure order covers not just the head office, but all Smart branches in the city, including those located in malls. Smart says it remains committed to complying with the Financial Hub's local tax ordinances. The firm adds it has now taken legal action to resolve the issue. Back in 2018, Smart filed a petition for review seeking to nullify the city treasurer's notice of assessment, which states the telco giant did not pay the franchise tax. The Philippine government is once again urged to rethink the country's ratification of RCEP, or the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. The deal eliminates up to 90% of tariffs among participating countries within 20 years. Now, independent think tank Ebon Foundation says the enhanced market access will benefit foreign investors rather than local producers.
Philippine production has collapsed to its lowest in at least 70 years in the case of manufacturing, in its history in terms of agriculture. When you talk about market access, the real beneficiaries of market access will be foreign investors who have located in the Philippines and now have actually reduced tariffs for their transport of goods between their own regional supply lines. So it's not going to be fundamentally the Philippine economy in terms of our local agriculture, local industry benefiting. It's going to be foreign investors who have taken over Philippine manufacturing. About 60-70% of Filipino manufacturing is not even Filipino. They will be the biggest beneficiaries of RCEP.
Ebon Foundation Executive Director Sunny Africa also warns the Philippines' existing trade deficits with its RCEP partner countries may worsen.
By reducing protections against imports from abroad, that will actually facilitate more trade in these goods into the country. But our biggest issue is actually the second layer of the problem. When those imports come in, if a lot of those are actually going to be imports of, for instance, foreign investors in special economic zones or foreign investors in their global supply chains, whatever export gains actually will not accrue to the Philippines, but will accrue to these foreign corporations here. At the very least, we will see additional pressure on our foreign exchange.
Grab Philippines at risk of facing new penalties. The Philippine Competition Commission is considering imposing a fine against Grab due to its failure to reimburse all eligible customers in a 2018 refund order. Now, according to the PCC, the company has only refunded around 70% of their customers. Since 2018, Grab has been slapped with a total of 60 million pesos in penalties for violating the price and service quality commitment.
Well, the first thing we do is we fine them for those violations, okay? And they've been paying it. And you know, if they don't correct those actions, then they'll continue to be paying it, and then there can be further proceedings against them. Whether their reasons are sufficient justification so that they shouldn't be penalized for failing to do the refund.
Grab, meanwhile, says it struggles to release the total amount of refunds as some of its customers have deleted their apps, while others do not have a wallet feature. Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla wants all banks to stop charging fees on small-value online transactions. He believes the practice is slowing progress towards financial inclusion. Warren de Guzman reports.
Fruit vendor Roberto Inocencio perked up after hearing about the Philippine Central Bank's initiative to eliminate fees on small-value transactions. He says for a small business owner like himself, small bank transfers happen on a daily basis and the fees can add up.
Minsan nakakadalawa, tatlo, ganun. Kaya minsan nababawasan ng mga 45 pesos sa isang araw. Siguro, maabutin siya ng may mga 600 aman.
Inocencio, 600 peso estimate is based on transfer fees of just 20 pesos a day. If we compute using his 45 peso a day estimate, the monthly total goes as high as 1,350 pesos. The Philippine Central Bank's schedule of transfer fees for InstaPay, the service used to handle transactions worth not more than 50,000 pesos, shows that while there are many banks and e-wallets that offer these services for free, many more charge between 8 pesos and 30 pesos per transaction. Many of these banks waive the same online transfer fees during the pandemic as a form of relief for their clients. Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla says no fee should be charged on transactions worth 500 pesos or less.
If somebody is just paying 200 pesos and he has to pay a 15, 20 peso transaction per transaction, that's a lot, right? So which this will discourage the use of digital payments for small transactions. So we are discussing with BAP how to make transactions free for small transactions.
Medallia says they are also willing to sweeten the deal for banks, allowing them to use more of their available cash through a more aggressive reduction of reserve requirements. Currently, the RRR stands at 12%.
We will reduce the RRR. We hope, in return, the banks will waive all fees on small transactions when people make bank-to-bank payments. We're literally bribing the banks to subsidize the small transactions. And from what I hear from the Bank Association, they are receptive to this.
Later on, however, Medallia clarified that such a cut in the RRR will still be determined by inflation and other data, as doing so while still hiking interest rates to curb inflation might confuse markets.
Of course, we will be more eager to cut the reserve requirements if they help us in this area. Like, kasi ang target namin na 10%, I think we can make it lower than 10%. I'm confident that it will happen soon. I'm sure the BAP is trying to, will work out a proposal that we can all agree would be the fair way of handling it.
Bankers Association of the Philippines President Tony Mangkupa says they fully support the central bank's objective of financial inclusion by democratizing online usage of financial services, which include reduction of bank-to-bank transfer fees. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.